Good afternoon.
Welcome you.
Guys, for the new guys who have not been here before, I welcome you to the hotel in the Campari Bar. Thank you for making time to pass by this week. Because this is something that we started on. Every Tuesday there were these classes. So every Tuesday from 2 p.m. we normally have these classes. Guys, it's a free class. From 2 p.m. it's a free class. And I just want to let you know that we need to make it more of a, let's be time conscious, guys. It's great to be time conscious so that we start early and then end early. Because, you know, this is an office. You know, the guys are down there who also want to leave. So I'm really happy to have you here. We're going to expand on this. We're going to make it even bigger. So because you're taking your names, you're going to open a group. We're going to make it kind of a routine. You know, what you've done this week is something different than you do next week. Because the main idea about this is to uplift the Kenyan bartender. As she has said, it's about confidence, it's about the passion, it's about the interest. Something I want to tell the new upcoming bartenders, you know, some of us are kind of becoming dinosaurs, yeah? Our time is kind of waning off. You know, in the modern world, in the known outlets, you know, let's say for instance in South Africa, in Dubai, in Europe, and other countries, bartenders have got signatures. What is your signature? What should you be known for? If I look at Karish, he has got his signature. I bet he really. That's his signature. And I look at Morgan. Morgan, tell you coffee, but that's not your signature. Yes. That's Morgan. Yeah? That's his signature. If you look at her, look at her hand. Yeah? She's got that amazing tattoo. So that's her signature. Guys, work on your signature. What are you for? My signature is just my flag. So guys, that coming bartenders, you need to always work on your seat. What should you be known for? I think that bartender would be very, very neat. A bow tie, or maybe a very slim tie, always with a nice looking apron, a half coat. You need to have your seat. That wherever you're working, maybe you're working in the bar, maybe you're going for an event, you must always have that. You should work on your signature. It's very, very much important. So from now on, start. Don't just go to work as if it's not only paying the bills. Guys, you must love this. Outside Africa, you guys are loving this, and guys are making money out of this. And we're really trying to get in that right direction. It's unfortunate that we haven't had such kind of seminars. I wouldn't call it a seminar, but such kind of meetings. You know, meet and greet kind of sessions with partners. We won't have that for a long time. But we're trying, we're going to work this, and also with other brand ambassadors, the likes of Ellen, the likes of Samia, the likes of, unfortunately, God is not here. But this is something that we started long ago, and we want to keep to it. In our bartender forum, please keep active. Keep it very, very much active. If you have got any issue, you have a question about the cocktail, now I've got the open forum, the bartender's forum. Guys, keep asking questions from there, because from there, that's when you learn. You learn from your mistakes. Keep asking these things, no matter how silly it is. It might be silly to you or someone else who maybe has a lot of knowledge, but there are 1, 2, 3, 4, even 20 people who that thing is going to help. So guys, work on your signature. What should you be known for? For more than I've known you like yourself, since days, about 10 years ago. Just keep treating it and all that. So always work on your signature. If you look at DMK dance, that has not his signature. He never loses that hat. Yeah? See, he always has that. That's his signature. So what we're hearing, just think about it. What is my signature? What should I be known for? What should I be known for? So to continue or to begin our session today, I'll hand over to Evans. Evans can hand over number one. You know, this is one of the red hands we have around. So I thank you for taking over when I was away, and my colleague Eugene. So hand over, then Eugene, then you go to the bar. And when we're finishing up, we'll finish up with beer tails. You know, so many of us don't know about the beer cocktails. So we'll do a few of the beer tails with some of the brands that we have in the bar. Otherwise, guys, feel most welcome. We are here for learning. We don't just here to consume. So let's make it more of a dialogue. So we'll have a toast. Eugene, you have to lead this. Yes.
So does everyone have a cup? Something that was 80%, but it has been watered down to 40% because then then again, in this country, we cannot have an alcohol of 80% here, the way we know our people. We know that we like to drink a lot. So by what have we done, we also try to maintain the relative strength, but also something that people can use in a bar. So right now, I'll ask you guys to just put, normally when you nose it, use the nose that is strongest. And try not to get a nose bar, not to call it. Keka kombe kwa mapua yungu nose at Jamaica. So I'll encourage you guys to start off with the nose that you feel is the best. I don't know what nose. So do you mean left hand or your right? From the smell, what are you able to smell? And the next thing you do is when you're taking it inside, set it up. When you sip it, put it in your tongue, let it sit on your tongue for a while and pick out the flavors.
Because when you're tasting any spirit, normally you have to think about, you know, the nose and the tongue go together. So when you have the flu, you find that chapulina conga tastes. You know, when your nose is just really open, when you still have the fragrance of a very sweet cooking food, they kind of start to salivate. So they kind of work together. So when you're nosing any spirit, actually kind of just pass it on the nose, or you can find it so that you get that spray. Don't just put your whole nose in it because you burn your sinuses. It's really to avoid destroying your sinuses, don't just put your nose in it. And then when you're tasting, assuming on the tongue, assuming this is our tongue, the tongue normally has the different segments. The upper part of the tongue normally tastes for any sugar, any sweetness. And then on the sides of the tongue, when you roll anything in the mouth, we'll pick any bitterness in any brush. And then if it has any aftertaste, you'll feel it deep down the throat. So you swallow it. If it's an aftertaste, you'll get it from there. So when you're tasting any brand, always think of that. It's amazing when you have a glass, you just like don't have glasses, you can swallow. You know, moving a bit like this is called swallowing. So if you kind of have some strands on the glass, those are called the legs, but in a proper glass, not this